The internet is really, really great for porn. Whoa, hey, what's up, Nerdgasm fans? Jerry here, aka Barnacles. And as you can see, I'm pretty bored. So we're gonna print some Legos on the Ultimaker 3D printer because nothing cures boredom like putting little pieces of plastic together. Woohoo! Alright guys, let's print some Legos. So I went ahead and picked up a model from a guy named Wizard23. You can get more information on the model in the description of the video. But we're going to go ahead and open it up. It's a parametric model that you can pretty much size to anything you want, but the two most common Lego bricks were included. So I went ahead and already created a whole array of them that we want to put onto the platform. So I'm going ahead and loading that right now. We're using Cura 13.06.4, which is their latest version of the software. And man, have they made some huge improvements. So here you can see the Legos. You can go ahead and move around, and this is actually a representation of the Ultimaker build platform, so you can kind of see exactly what it's going to look like when you're done printing. And you can go ahead and look around it. If you've watched my other videos, you've already seen this. You can see, you know, they look like regular Legos. They interconnect using the same type of mechanics. So here on the bed, I went ahead and set these and arranged them in order, so each one will print one by one. So this one will print, then this one will print, then this one will print, so on and so forth. And it basically arranges them in such a way that the print head won't collide, but it can complete an entire Lego before it continues. And the main reason for doing that is it would take forever if it had to do one layer here, print another layer, move. That's a whole lot of unnecessary movement of the print head. So the idea here is that it prints one complete Lego and then moves to the next, which is much more efficient and saves a lot of time. Doesn't save anything on plastic or anything like that, but it does save an awful lot of time. I'm printing with the default settings, although I did set the layer height to 0.1 millimeter because when you're dealing with Legos, it's really tight tolerances. And plus, we're printing in PLA, which is a much more rigid plastic than ABS. So in order for these things to fit together, you're going to want those tolerances to be extra tight. So now that we got this laid out, I went ahead and already took the liberty of saving this to the SD card that we're going to put into the Ultimaker controller so that the unit can print autonomous, because I don't like leaving it connected to the computer. You can leave it connected to the computer and have Cura do all the printing for you. You can just literally go up to File and go to Print. And it shows you some cool stats and everything, but I just don't want to risk the computer locking up or having a glitch or the program crashing and then wasting all that plastic. So for this, I use the Ultimaker controller. You just put in an SD card, you say go, and boom, you're printing. So let's get these things going so that we can start farting around with these Legos.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Well, here we have the finished Legos that we just printed off the Ultimaker 3D printer. You can see right here I printed two different types. I have one that has hollow cylinders and then one that has solid cylinders because I wanted to see which ones worked best. And there was two versions of it from Wizard 23. And the first thing I'll tell you is the blocks fit very, very snugly together. So much, in fact, that I'm actually having a hard time separating these three right here. So if you do print these blocks, you will have to wear them in. So connect them, disconnect them, connect them, disconnect them, and they will eventually get really, really easy to put together. But you can see right here, they're actually very, very precise. And to prove how precise they are, I can snap them together. You can see they're super, super, super snug. I mean, to get them apart takes quite a bit of effort, which a lot of people would say is actually pretty cool. So we'll go ahead and interconnect a couple of these. And just like that, make a little staircase here. I'll even put the big piece up here on top. But as you can see, that demonstrates these actually are functional Lego blocks. And they are compatible with actual Legos. I should say these are not Legos. These are actually Lego-like blocks. But they actually will work with regular Legos too. Unfortunately, I don't have any real Legos available to me right now. Hence why I printed them, because I felt like playing with Legos. So the little blocks, you see, just snap right on. You can see the Ultimaker printer prints to such a good precision that you can actually print out interlocking plastic blocks. Now, Legos have to be printed to a perfect tolerance to function. And as you can see here, they do. But I was actually pretty surprised at how good of a job it did. I mean, these blocks, they fit really snugly together. They're not even printed in ABS, they're printed in PLA. Which actually makes them much more rigid than ABS is. But I could see, I mean, the potential for this being huge. Think about it. You could model your own blocks that could connect, you know, like Lincoln Logs in these or a Rector set in these. You could create all kinds of conversion blocks that would let you intermingle different sets of blocks, which, you know, Lego, they wouldn't create those parts because they don't want people to use the competitors' products. But you technically could. But as you can see, both the hollow and the solid pieces work equally well. And they do snap right together. The pieces are very, very uniform and flat. I printed with default settings. I did set the fan to come on after the fifth layer. I didn't say that earlier in the video. Just to avoid some warping, because if you look on some of these early printed pieces, I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but there's a slight gap. It doesn't affect how they connect together, but it was from it trying to peel away from the platform because the fan was coming on too early. But with a little bit of tweaking, depending on your environment, your humidity and temperature, you can actually get your printer printing stuff like this that's ultra precise. And come on, let's face it. If you can print a Lego, you can print just about anything because these things are so tightly fit together. I mean, if it was off by more than a tenth of a millimeter, probably, these wouldn't snap together. And they do. And the more you use them, the better they work because they do actually wear in. But there you have it. Now I could just print out tons of Legos and build something. Well, there you have it, Nerdgasm fans. Yet another use for the Ultimaker 3D printer. I went ahead and created my own Legos or Lego-like compatible blocks, mega blocks, whatever they call them these days. But anyways, as you can see, they actually interlock. This does work with PLA, which is actually a big surprise. I thought that I'd have to use ABS because ABS is more flexible. But as you can see here, it actually works. Here's some pieces interconnected. They freestand on their own. And like I said, you do have to wear them in over time. Just keep connecting them and disconnecting. And eventually they get really, really well mated to each other and everything fits just perfectly. But you can see there, I've created every block I've printed so far works and snaps together and breaks apart. So guys, I hope this video gave you a nerdgasm. If it didn't, let me know in the comments. If it did, let me know in the comments. You guys know I love reading your comments. I'm not one of those huge YouTubers that ignores all of his users. I actually look forward to waking up every morning and going through all my comments. Hell, usually I'm sitting on the pot with either a Nexus 7, an iPad, or a Microsoft Surface answering all your guys' comments and questions and stuff. So please leave them. And if you wouldn't mind hitting that subscribe button, it helps me out a bunch. And check out my other videos. If you like this one, chances are you'll like some of the other stuff I make. So guys, again, hope it gave you a nerdgasm. Till next time.
I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, favorite, and subscribe. It helps me a bunch. Also, come follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I love interacting with you guys. We'll be right back.